Good morning everyone. For the today's session, we are going to see some kind of an examples related with uniform plane wave. Okay, so let's start. So this one is an first example. The problem is given as a uniform plane wave of 50 hertz propagating through a copper conducting having sigma is equal to 6.8 into 10 raised to 7 mho per meter, epsilon r is equal to 1 and mu r is equal to 1 also, and we are supposed to calculate the attenuation constant, phase constant beta, propagation constant gamma, intrinsic impedance, wavelength, phase velocity and depth of penetration. Now let's start, just move towards the solution. So the first one, we know that for the good conductors, we have already seen this condition is that sigma divided by omega epsilon is always greater than 1. So this one is a condition we have just gone through about the good conductors. So we are putting down these values over here, and that is an first of all, a sigma, it is given that an it is given value as an 6.8 into 10 raised to 7. So we have just put it down. Omega is nothing but an 2 pi f. So it is an 2 pi, the frequency given in the example itself, it is 50 hertz. So it is an 50 into sigma value, it is already given as 1 into 8.85 into 10 raised to minus of 12. Okay, so it is equal to, if we are going to be solid, it is given as 2.44 into 10 raised to 16. Now, this value is very, very greater than 1. That is, we can say that it is for the good conductor. Now, we are just moving towards our first problem. That is, we are supposed to calculate the attenuation constant. Now, we have to calculate this attenuation constant for the good conductors, and that's why we are keeping down the formula for the good conductors. Alpha is equal to under root omega mu sigma divided by 2. So, it is given as 2 omega. Omega here we are going to use as 2 pi f. So, instead of omega, it is 2 pi f value. It is given as an 50 hertz. Then, it is given as an mu already we know that it is given with an 4 pi into 10 raised to minus 7, and sigma it is we have just given in the examples, it is nothing but 6.8 into 10 raised to my 10 raised to 7 mho. So we have just put it down, and if we solve this one, we will be just come to the conclusion that alpha it is given as 115.85 meter raised to minus 1. So it is per meter, attenuation constant. Then nextly we are asked to calculate the phase constant. It is nothing but an beta. So again we know that the beta is also given as same, that as this one is an good conductor, so beta is also given as omega mu epsilon divided by 2. So again its value will becomes as an 115.85 rad per meter. Now attenuation constant, gamma we know that alpha plus j beta, we know the value of alpha, we know the value of beta, so we are just putting it down, alpha and j beta, so it will becomes as 115.85 plus j 115.85 meter raised to minus 1 or per meter, isn't it? Now nextly we are going to be calculate the intrinsic impedance eta. So according to the formula, intrinsic impedance for the good conductors on the plane wave, it is given as eta is equal to under root j omega mu divided by sigma, j omega mu divided by sigma. So it is given as j omega, again we are using omega is equal to 2 pi f. So j will be remains as it is, 2 pi into f, it is value is given as an 50, and mu is value is already constant, it is given as an 4 pi into 10 raised to minus 7. As this one is an a good conductor, so we are using the value of mu for the it is an a constant, directly we are going to be calculate, it is an a 4 pi into 10 raised to minus 7. Sigma, it is given as an a conductivity, 6.8 into 10 raised to 7, its value is already given. So if we are going to be solid, it will become as an